Hey, what's up guys, it's Psycho or Sam here and welcome back to another video guys, and today we're gonna talk a little bit about how powerful PC do you need for game development, because a lot of people have been asking me this question regarding how powerful your PC has to be, how much of a battle station you need to have actually in order to get into game development. And by replying to all comments, I feel like I'm not doing that much of a work. So I felt like I could actually make a video about this since it's a very heat topic on my channel, it seems. So with that being said, guys, we're gonna get started with this video. And before that, I just want to mention that I'm so thankful for all the support you guys have been giving me. It's incredible that you're supporting me so much on my videos and on my channel in general. And I just hope that this interactivity with you guys really just keeps on going. And I want to thank you for everything. And with that being said, guys, let's jump right into the video. So I want to start by talking about my own specs here. And first and foremost, I want to name my processor, the CPU. So it's an Intel Core i5. 4440 for those geeks of you. It's a CPU and we also have 10.10 gigahertz on it. I am not really that much of a spec guy, to be completely honest with you guys, and I'm really, really bad at specs actually, especially when it comes to processors. But basically, I have quite a fast CPU. It's not the best, obviously, it's not the best in the market, but an i5 is pretty much just like more than enough for my own sake. And game development doesn't really affect your CPU that much, but it's still recommended that you kind of have like over i3 from what I read. And I'm just like quoting other people and also from my own experiences, because I also had a laptop before with an i3. It worked perfectly fine. Like I could run Unity, but I'm not really sure about Unreal because I didn't try Unreal back then. But basically i5, 4440, I don't know what that means, but it's kind of like just more than enough for me. I never felt like I need to upgrade my CPU, honestly. And even if I render like videos, it's going really, really fast. As a standard video card, a GPU, I have an Intel HD Graphics 4600, which I never use, but I still want to name it because it's a part of my computer. It's like a built-in GPU that almost every computer has. And then my video card number two, which is the primary one that I use, is an NVIDIA GeForce GTX 950. So I had a GeForce GTX 650 by NVIDIA too, and I felt like it wasn't enough at all. Like I felt like 900 series was like the minimum for me to go, from what I read on YouTube. Like I seeked up on a few videos and, you know, looked up on Google or whatever, and even on Unity's forums, because people were discussing about this before. So I found out that 900 series plus was really, really good, and I went with a 950, and I'm really, really happy because I get a lot of good performance and I get to keep my visual quality for my level designs, which look beautiful in my YouTube videos, and that's exactly what I needed. But if you need like incredible power, obviously you can go with higher GTX cards or whatever kind of brand you want to go with. But I felt like NVIDIA is really, really good, and GTX 950 was more than enough for me. And even today, I don't feel like I have to upgrade. Like maybe in a year or a couple of years, I will feel like I need to update or upgrade. But right now, I'm more than happy with it. And by RAM, I also have 8 GB RAM. So it's more than enough for multitasking. Like 8 GB is really just enough, like straight up. I had a friend who was really active with like computer specs, and he even told me that when I was gonna purchase this computer, he was like, you don't need a better RAM, like 8 GB is really, really good. So I went with 8 GB, and I never actually felt like I need more, because multitasking is perfectly fine on the computer. And not only that, but you know, having like multiple softwares like Audacity, Unity, Premiere, Photoshop, like literally I don't usually keep them open at the same times, but when I do have like Premiere and Photoshop in order to create my video or like edit the video and then render it, and also like have a Photoshop screen on the other monitor where I just kind of like edit my thumbnails, it's working perfectly fine. And even when I work on Unity and record it at the same time, it doesn't like affect it at all. So my performance stands really, really good because of the RAM, and I'm really happy with 8 GB, and I don't feel like anybody else would need more than that. But then again, I'm not really that much of a specs guy, so there's probably something that I'm missing out on. But like, if you're not looking into micro details, you should be fine with 8 GB. And then last but not least, we also have a operating system, the OS, which is a Microsoft Windows 10. It's a 64-bit and it's working perfectly fine, even though it's not really that much related to my specs. So to the most important part of this video, how good performance and quality do I have? I have always got the highest resolution on Unity and also the highest quality in terms of how shadows look, like very high resolution on shadows in Unity's quality settings, and I never really experienced any issues, even though I have like a lot of filled levels on my videos, especially because I'm using so much grass, so much trees. I have so many post-processing scripts added to my main cameras, and it's just working perfectly fine. And if I have to define perfectly fine, I mean like 60 plus FPS on my level designs, most of them at least. If I go out of my way a little bit, maybe I drop down to like 30, 40, but it's still fine, especially for like a speed level design video, so it's more than good for me at least. If you're a good level designer, you're gonna be able to optimize your levels so good that you're gonna be able to work with any specs at all, as long as they meet the minimum criteria for Unity or whatever engine you're using. And I'm not saying that I'm an incredible level designer, but because I know how to optimize my levels and my sceneries, I never encounter any performance trouble when I'm making my videos or my level designs for my customers. Speaking of which, guys, we're gonna talk a little bit about recommended minimum specs, and we're also gonna talk a little bit about recommended general specs by like where I'm basically going to base it on upon people that I read off of like Reddit and other websites. So I found an interesting forum thread here on the Unreal Engine forum, and somebody was asking for good computer specs for game development, pretty much our topic right here. And he was saying that UE4 is constantly crashing, and he has like a 4 GB of RAM, and a lot of people, and this thread is from 2016, so it's not really that old. But at the same time, people were like, well, 4 GB is not enough for as a RAM. You should get an 8 GB plus. And people were even suggesting like their own builds where they have like 32 freaking gigabytes, which is incredible. Like it's not needed. I mean, honestly, like if you're gonna get started with game development, you shouldn't have to get like the top computer in the freaking market. Like you should be able to go with a 4 to 8 GB RAM. I don't want to give you like a wrong number because I never personally tried 4 GB, but basing on what people say here on this forum thread and based upon what I read from the internet before, 8 GB should be good to go. And I personally have a 8 GB too, and it's working more than fine for me, and people don't suggest you 4 GB. So I would say if you're gonna go with a RAM, like a custom built PC, or if you're gonna purchase it, go with an 8 GB for minimum. And if you feel like you have a little bit more budget, like left a little bit more money for yourself, go with something higher. But 8 GB should be very good to go. You'll also see a lot of people that are suggesting like GTX 1080 because they have it and their battle stations are like ridiculously good. But I would say that for a minimum, you should go with like a GTX 900 series plus. If you're not going with AMD, if you're going with AMD, I'm not really sure because I never actually used it before. So I can't really, like, I don't want to lie to you guys and be like, hey, you should go with this because obviously I don't know about it. And I couldn't really find that much info about it on the internet either. And even if I do read them, I'm not gonna like know a lot because I'm obviously not the specs guy, especially when it comes to AMDs. So if you're gonna go with Nvidia as a brand, I would suggest you 900, GTX 900 Plus series because they're gonna be very, very good. Under that, it's gonna feel like it's almost obsolete, even though it's not literally, like technically it's not, but it's just going to feel too old when you're using it, and it's going to be a little bit laggy if you're like having the top-notch quality in Unity even, and then you're trying to make a big level. So go with 900 plus. Now that you're getting started into it and you want to get into game development a little bit more serious than other people, just invest a little bit extra. Like it's not that much of a big gap in between these two prices for 900 plus and let's say 700 plus, right? Or 600 plus. So just go with a 900 plus, and if you feel like in a year you feel like, hey, I should upgrade, then go with it. But you should start a little bit smaller and build your way up from there depending on your budget. As a processor, guys, for the CPU part of this video, I would suggest you an i5 plus, not only because I have it, but I have tried the i3 for my old laptop, and it also didn't have that much of a good, you know, graphics card. It had like a really old Nvidia, but i3 was really not enough. Like it's just not good enough for level designing or whatever game development you're getting into. If you're gonna export your project, you're gonna have to like bake your lighting, have to render your lighting, render your post-processing. It's not going to work as well. Like it's not. I would definitely not suggest you to start off with an Intel i3. Like if you're gonna go like good to go, if you want to be good to go with a CPU, I would strongly suggest you an i5 just to get you started. If you want to go a little bit more ham, go for an i7. I had an i7 on my, not my previous, or actually, yeah, my previous laptop, not this, the one that I talked about where it had i3. I don't know why my current computer has i5, but whatever. i7, I had it, and it was good enough, but honestly, like, to be completely honest with you guys, I didn't nitpick that much, so I didn't really realize that much of a difference between i5 and i7. Now, people will be telling me in the comments that, oh my god, Psycho, you're so ignorant when it comes to CPUs, but I'm really not this fixed, guys, like, I'm just not. And I'm not, once again, I like never nitpick when it comes to performance in terms of CPU. When it comes to GPU, I understand a little bit more because it's more related to it. But CPUs are remotely related, so I'm not really that sure about them. But I never really found any differences between i7 and i5 on my own like personal experience. So if you want to go ham, go for an i7, but I never really found any difference. So I also want to talk a little bit about Unity and Unreal Engine comparisons. So a lot of people are like, well, I want to get started in Unity, or like I want to get started in Unreal Engine. What are the differences in terms of what specs I need? Like, do I need a ham battle station for Unreal while in Unity I can just use any battle station? And I would definitely say, like, as a person who's used both engines for a while now, especially in terms of where I level design a lot, I would say that Unity and Unreal Engine do have their own like differences, and there is quite a wide gap in between them in terms of quality. Because Unreal Engine has standard, by default, added post-processing. So when you're gonna get into Unreal Engine and start editing your maps, if you make them quite big, you're gonna realize that it lags quite easily. Meanwhile, in Unity, because they don't have these standard image effects added to your camera from the beginning of the scene, you're gonna realize that it's not really that laggy. But the more you keep on adding your, you know, shaders and all these post-processing image effects, whatever, the more you add them, the more it's going to lag, obviously, like it's normal. It does on not every computer, even if you have the best computer in the world. But it's just, there is a gap in between them. And if you're going to go with Unity, I would say that, or actually, if you're going to go with Unity or Unreal Engine, I would definitely say that the specs that I recommended you guys as a recommended minimum specs, the previous point of this video, I would say that they are enough for both Unity and Unreal Engine for you to make a good game and for you to make a good level or whatever you're making, right? But for example, if you go with an i3 as a CPU, perhaps you're gonna have like a little bit easier in Unity because it's not going to add your standard image effects by default. But when you get into Unreal Engine, you're gonna realize a little bit lag. And even like I have an i5, I have a GTX 950 once again, like I talked about my own specs. And I never ever experienced any issues in either Unity or Unreal Engine. And Unreal Engine is known for having very good graphics by standard. So if you're gonna be able to use Unreal Engine, you should be able to use any other engine without any lag, in my opinion. As long as they are advanced and as long as they are, you know, optimized for whatever computer you're using, you should be good to go. But that was pretty much it for this video, guys. I really hope you all enjoyed this video, and if you did, make sure to leave a like down below. And also let me know in the comments if you enjoyed the video and what you would like to see for the next video. If you have any video ideas, if you have any suggestions for me, let me know. I always write them down, and I kind of just try my best to make them all so that a lot of people get their voices heard on the channel. And while you're on it, guys, don't forget to hit the subscribe button down below also to stay up to tune for new cool content like this one. There's going to be a lot more videos, and I'm gonna try my best to focus a lot more on level designs from now on too, so that I don't throw them out. I'm just trying to get used to my new working schedule, so as soon as I feel like I'm ready, I'm gonna start making videos every day. So yeah, you heard it correct. It's going to be every day. And guys, before I end the video, I was also thinking of like a video series ideas where I could like make gameplay videos on games that you guys would like me to analyze and see what the specific features are, and then I could start like a tutorial series on that game specifically for how to make features that are included in that game. It's really clumsy right now, but I can finish the like finalize and put my last touches into it and make it sound better. But if you feel like this is a cool idea for any video series, let me know. And with that being said, guys, I want to thank you for once again for all the support on my videos and on my channel. I appreciate every single one of you. And I'm so glad that I got myself back running into replying to everyone's comments. And with that being said, I'll catch you guys in the comments. See you guys. Peace out. Bye bye.